Greetings, this is Ken Drews from the National Weather Service in Tucson. Monsoon Safety Awareness Week begins Sunday, June 9th and continues through Friday, June 14th. Each day, a different topic will be highlighted on National Weather Service webpages and social media channels. Today's topic will provide a general introduction to the monsoon. We'll also take a look at the precipitation outlook for this year's monsoon. The goal of Monsoon Safety Awareness Week is to reduce the number of deaths, injuries, and property damage caused by weather-related dangers that occur during the monsoon. Through a collaborative effort between National Weather Service offices serving the states of Arizona and New Mexico, the time period from June 15th through September 30th has been defined as the monsoon. This fits in well with the Arabic definition of the word for season, or mawsim. Since monsoon means season, it's fitting that our general weather pattern changes during the onset of the monsoon. The maps here show how the average position of subtropical high pressure shifts from June into July, changing our general wind pattern from one blowing from west to east to one that is dominated by moist but markedly weaker flow coming out of the south or southeast. This influx of moisture leads to frequent rounds of thunderstorms, which causes average rainfall to ramp up as the summer progresses, peaking in July and August and waning again in September. In this series of maps, heavier average rain amounts are indicated in orange and red. In this series of maps, the amount of rain that fell in 2012 is compared to average. Greens and blues indicate areas which received more rain than average for that particular month in 2012, while yellows and oranges show where it was drier than normal. As you can see, and one might expect, a few areas near the international border received rain as early as the latter part of June. Many more locations received above average rainfall in July, although eastern Cochise County in the southeast corner of the state remained dry. In August of 2012, most areas experienced below normal precipitation, after which a return to average or above average rainfall returned to much of southern Arizona during September. This table shows average monsoon rainfall amounts from a few specific locations across Arizona. In the far right column, monsoon rainfall amounts from 2012 are shown. As you can see, several locations shown were wetter than normal, while others were drier than normal, and Tucson and Phoenix were both fairly close to average. So what can we expect this year? The official prediction from the Climate Prediction Center calls for equal chances of receiving nearly average, above normal, or below normal rainfall from July through September, which, as you saw from the table just shown, can be a fairly realistic result across a broad area. The official temperature forecast, which is not shown here, calls for a good chance for temperatures to average above normal during July, August, and September across all of Arizona. Shown here are maps of sea surface temperatures in the Pacific. While currently there is neither an El Niño or a La Niña established, meaning there hasn't been a longer-term, broad warming or cooling of the equatorial ocean waters this spring, sea surface temperatures is one large-scale factor which can affect how our monsoon evolves. While not identical, the sea surface temperature anomalies, or how the temperatures compare to long-term averages for the date, were similar in early June of 2012 to what has been measured recently. This could be one indication that we could start off our monsoonal rains in an active fashion similar to last year, but as we saw previously, precipitation can vary greatly from month to month and from place to place. Thus, after all is said and done, there are no strong indications for the monsoon being either wetter or drier than normal in any given location across Arizona. More information about seasonal forecasting, monsoon statistics, and monsoon safety is online at the link shown here. We hope you enjoyed this presentation. Thank you for your time, and stay safe.